Hello, and welcome to Data Science Wednesday. My name is Tessa Jones, and I'm a data scientist with Decisive Data. And today we're going to talk about how to deconstruct a data science question and why it matters. Before I start diving into things, I wanted to add a little caveat that I am a scientist and I love chemistry, and so we're going to talk about things in terms of molecules and elements, so prepare yourself. Let's walk through this per usual with an example. I feel like usually that helps to really bring the point across. So let's start with a really big business question. Let's pretend that you're a marketing person and you need to know how and when should we market particular products. Really good, important question for you to understand. Now, this question by itself, we really can't answer because we need to know a lot more information. We need to know information about our product demand, we need to know information about our sales, and we need to know information about our customers. So that's the beginning of the deconstruction process. So let's look at this first one right here. What does our product demand look like? We're going to think about it in terms of a product demand molecule. So this molecule answers this question, and it's built by elements. These are constructed of your elemental questions. So we have our elemental questions over here about what our product demand might look like. And those elemental questions are, what is the seasonality of our products? What is the growth or decline of our products? What is the relationship of our products? Can products be grouped by common attributes? All of these elemental questions build our product demand molecule that answers this question, which then tells us what particular products we should market to. If we continue on with this example, we also know that we need to understand what will our sales look like in the future. So we'll call this our future sales molecule. And all the elements that compose that are listed here. What attributes impact demand the most? What is our sales seasonality? And at what granularity do we want to build a forecast model from? Once we know all of these elemental questions, we can have our future sales molecule built. And if we continue down to the last one we discussed, what is our customer segmentation? Understanding who we want to market to and what that might look like. And in order to build our customer segmentation molecule, we want to understand what attributes define a customer and are there specific attributes that drive demand more than others. Once we understand this, we have our customer segmentation molecule. And now we can answer all of these molecular questions. And so once we combine all three of these together, then we get a really good picture that allows us to answer our global question of how and when should we market particular products. And to add, if you go through the process this way, you're really getting added business value at every step of the way. Because it does have a lot of value to answer these elemental questions. What attributes define a customer? That's pretty good information to have. And it's even better information to understand what specific attributes are driving demand. These are important by themselves. Once you put them together, then you can answer questions about customer segmentation, which is even more powerful. Once you combine that with all these other molecular level questions, then we have even more powerful questions to answer. So to kind of wrap up, we start with a very big global question. And by deconstructing that question into the molecular and elemental questions that support that global question, we can not only get to a really good business value output, but we can also have value all along the way. Thanks for joining us today. My name is Tessa Jones with Decisive Data.